Here tonight, the junior and senior girls will battle in the 29th annual Powder Puff game. Earlier this week, we talked with some of the NHS members who told us about the game.
Powder Puff is a football game held at many high schools around the country. At West Allegheny, Powder Puff is a football game held for the senior girls versus the junior girls. It's a lot of fun, it's flag football, and the girls who participate in it really enjoy themselves.
All of the proceeds from this game will be benefiting Christmas families, so NHS will go out and buy toys for children of underprivileged families. And if you'd like to make a donation, you can contact Mrs. Lambert or ask the high school office.
Last year, the seniors won 26-0, and with history on their side, the senior girls have won 20 of the 27 Powder Puff games. This year, the juniors are looking for revenge, and tonight's game is sure to be a good one.
Are you walking out now?
We're back live here at Joe P. DeMcCullough Stadium. Juniors have just arrived on the home side of the bench area to the left of the press box. Again, we're moving from left to right, so the juniors will occupy around the 30-yard line. Seniors will be coming in shortly.
Down there celebrating before the game.
A couple of things going on to bring you up to speed. History has been on again the senior side. Seniors out of the 29 times have won 22. Juniors have won 6 with one tie. That tie coming in the first year of 1985 with 12-12. Again, last 3 years have been on the senior side of life. 2010, there was a 32-6 win by the seniors. In 2011, 7-6, a close one. And last year, 26-0. Also like to make sure we give a round of applause and thanks for our faculty sponsors on the junior side, Mrs. Denk, Mrs. Jones, and Mr. Mills. On the senior side coaching staff, Ms. Fox, Mrs. White, and Mr. Shepard. And here comes the seniors through the runway sign. Nobody has tripped over the sign. That's a good sign athletically for tonight. As the seniors congregate at midfield, there seems to be something coming out of an aerosol can, maybe hairspray, we're not sure.
Yes.
I'm Mike Ross.
And I'm Eli Katsavich.
And we will be your announcers for this evening's game.
Coming to midfield, we have our junior and senior captains shaking hands again with the two PIAA officials.
Seniors look to come off of a devastating loss from last year with a victory over the juniors this year.
Junior captains from our vantage point look like number 82, Emily Kiss, number 96, Janelle Lukovitz, and number 39, Audra Killen. The juniors have won the toss and will receive. They will receive to our right from the press box side. Shaking of hands, congratulatory. That'll be the last time this is congenial tonight because these girls are going to get at it. We also want to thank longtime photographer for the athletic department of school district, Mr. Paul DeBoer, who makes his way off the field. Paul always has his lens in focus. Obviously, we want to thank the boys in the booth here tonight, able to put this on the air for everybody's enjoyment. As we get set for tonight's contest, again, field conditions are not a factor this evening due to the artificial surface. Put down at the GOP D. McCullough Stadium in 2007, we are in our seventh season of use. Mr. Shepherd from the senior side of life, he's coming over to talk with the PIAA officials, making sure that everything's kosher. Weather conditions just popped up on my screen by the boys in the booth. 42 degrees, 10% chance of rain with a wind chill of 31. Wind, we're not sure where it's coming out at, but I'm sure the guys will have that, plus a barometric pressure and Thanksgiving forecast by the end of the broadcast. Just want to let you know that if the NSA or FBI is listening, I have nothing to do with this. Like we're having last-minute instructions for everybody. Mrs. Denk makes her way off the field, cheering her girls on as she does. Seniors now come on for the kickoff. The fans are still pouring in here as this game gets ready to kick off.
Kicking off for your 2013 seniors is Maggie Kelly. Maggie Ingram, that is.
Maggie Ingram gets set to kick off the ball. Wait, we have a late addition to the kickoff roster for the seniors. Realignment.
And here we are, the first moments of the game.
And we're off. She puts the ball down over the head of the first girl. Ball goes into the end zone. We will have a touchback. Ball comes out for the juniors. First and 10 at the 20-yard line. Nice kick by Maggie Ingram in the air from the 40. Lands at least until the 20-yard line. I'm not sure, we have to get confirmation on this, whether or not Coach Palka's doing some scouting at this game tonight for potential backup kickers for the rest of the season. Looks like we're getting our stick crew set across the field from us. All right, juniors come out in the first offensive set.
This senior defense looks fired up and ready to allow no yardage. Number 30, Lauren Costa, the Reaper.
Well, we need one piece of equipment. That's important. That's a ball. That's making its way onto the field. Number 13, quarterback Taylor Hottenfeller recognizes that immediately. And we are going shotgun. Trips right, sidecar behind her, single wide out to the left.
Formation for the juniors. MNC passes it off.
Toss sweep to the left. We have some speed. She's all the way down. She's going. Uh-oh. We got a breakaway. Riley Kane, first carry, first play of the offensive side of the ball for the juniors, and she goes 80 yards, scoring touchdown for the juniors.
A little bit of a celebration by the junior sidelines there.
Great blocking, seam blocking on that. put a hat on a hat, made sure that everybody was where they needed to be, and she ran 80 yards nearly untouched down the left sideline. Extra point to come. So much excitement after that first touchdown run that we're having a little difficulty assembling everybody on the field. Now we're moving out there. We are going to be attempting a point after touchdown with a kick.
The juniors will prepare for a PAT.
Number 87, T-Savvy, Tara Savisky, lining up. It's up and it's good. Tara Savisky puts it through the uprights. Juniors leading 7-0 in the first quarter here at Joe P. DeMcCullough Stadium.
How will the seniors respond to this?
Our yardage engineers, the guys on the chains, didn't have much to do on that one, so they're taking a little bit of a breather. As always, in the right-hand, bottom right-hand corner of your screen, you see Mr. Matt Treves, our the perennial
team following that touchdown from Candy Kane, Riley Kane.
Matt is always does an excellent job with his hands in his pockets. Actually, he does a great job for us, and we're very pleased to have Matt here. Taking care of all of our sports medicine needs from UPMC.
Why can't you stop the clock?
No, it's a running clock.
We have a running clock tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry for not letting everyone know.
Just been informed by our PA announcers that we do have a running clock, so you can see in the top of your screen there. And the ticker, 3 minutes and 10 seconds as the juniors get ready to kick off. Again, that's T-Savvy. She boots it. Lands on the 30. Picked up by number 27 on the seniors. Number 27, Jenny Krisnick. Jay Kriz with the return. From about the 30 to about the 35-yard line. Tackled by number two, Rachel Buckwild. Seniors start at their own 32-yard line, first and 10.
Senior offense takes the field.
Defense has set another defender running out on the field. Shotgun, handoff, right side, flag. Not just one flag. The whole belt was. Number
80.
Yeah, number seven. Number 87 was tackled by number 7, my spotter tells me.
And the junior defense will start this off with a tackle for a loss. What do you think about that there, Eli? Good stuff.
Seniors huddling. Getting ready to come out of the break, the huddle. Juniors are in position already, four deep across the back in the backfield, defensive backfield. Playing three-man front straight up the middle.
Shotgun formation by the seniors. Aubrey Ayers in the ball.
Oh! Aubrey Ayers tries to air the ball out a little bit.
Almost.
Pass was broken up by the defender in that secondary of the junior class. Pass broken up by number 18, Caitlin Cicillo. Killer Kate it says here on our roster as a nickname, Killer Kate, number 18. A plethora of Indians come onto the field as a number of seniors leave, so we have a large substitution. Probably will not be an unusual sight tonight. Large substitutions going on and off the field at different times. Junior Sarah Davis, number 6, Smalls, goes out and gets the kicking tee.
Shotgun
approach with two back set. Oh, we do have a penalty on the juniors.
A little too hasty on that one.
Looks like number 5, Cassidy Lally, or Lollipop, encroachment on a defense. We have 3rd and 8.
Pitches
to the left. Oh, we got a tackle there by the defensive backfield. Coming up on the play, number 24, Christy Rosem, Crust is the nickname given to her tonight. She makes a tackle. We now have a 4th and 5. 4th and 5 for the senior class. Correction, 4th and 4 for the seniors.
Scheming something good. Steaming from the ears a bit, seems kind of angry.
Not really.
Looks like that is the end of the first quarter.
Mr. Shepard, one of the more finest geography teachers at West Allegheny High School.
At the end of the first quarter, your score, juniors 7, seniors nothing. Let's break for 10 seconds for station identification. Tonight's broadcast is exclusive property of the West Allegheny Sports Network. Any reuse or rebroadcast without the express written consent of the West Allegheny Athletic Department is prohibited. Chains get moved by the yardage engineers with the assistance of our POW officials tonight.
Coach Mills talking to the juniors. Will Mills is also a winter track coach and track coach, maybe giving some speed talk. Are getting into formation, but seniors are still in the
house.
This just in. Over the text airways, mother of number 6, Sarah Davis, is correcting me. Yes, Mrs. Davis, I'm sorry. Sarah was the person running that ball down 80 yards. Should have recognized that from her track days here at West Allegheny, running a 4x4. So I apologize, Mrs. Partika, for not recognizing your niece, Sarah Davis, number 6, with her blazing speed. She's still typing, as I can see on my iPhone. Hopefully it's something pleasant, because I will have to see her at work tomorrow. Okay, we have some changing of the side of the ball again. Not sure what's Coach Shepard, being geography, knows the landscape here. Obviously, he's getting animated and trying to express his point that yes, there is an equator, and this is not it.
Mr.
Mr. Shepard, knowing the landscape of this very field, probably came out here before it. Get the feel for it. We're coaching the seniors. Junior is still in the huddle.
Okay, we now have first and 10, looks like, for the junior class, starting at the 40-yard line. Might be a rule change. Might be a rule here. We're not sure about that. Coach Mills coming out, regrouping the juniors.
Coach Mills.
Till that ball snap, we're still sitting at 8 minutes for this quarter. Coach Mills exits the field. Here we go. Oh, number four for the juniors. Mackenzie Johnson, awkward was her nickname, and might describe that pass out to the left flat as well. Incomplete. Attempted receiver, we believe, was number two, Buck Wild, Rachel Buck. Second and 10 from the 40 for the juniors. Seniors come to the line defensively, playing a four-man front, three-man front with an outside rush in on each side, two backers. Pass play. Johnson scrambles to the left. Almost takes out the official. She keeps going. No. Mackenzie Johnson sprints to the left. Sprints to the left side. Looks like she's going to be juniors on that quarterback keeper to the left side. We have wholesale changes here for the juniors as more juniors come off, so more juniors got to go back on. Girls, there's 11 on each side of the ball. Just keep that in mind. Oh, high snap. We got a high snap. Sarah Davis picks it up on the left-hand side. She goes. Oh, and they do pick up her belt. About a one-yard gain, maybe not even a one-yard gain.
Small Sarah Davis on the run. But it actually seems we have a fourth down here.
That tackle made by number 69, Megan Stripp, Megatron. Was in on that tackle. Sarah Davis was able to pick up that ball scrappily and motor out to the left-hand side, attempting to get in front of that lead marker at the 50. So we have a fourth and two.
Coach Mills with the signals from the sidelines. Riding the horse there.
We're riding five wide here with wideouts. We got a reverse with a – It's fumbled. They don't realize you can pick the ball up and go. They don't realize that. Oh, maybe there is a rule change. Okay. All right, ball is dead at the spot of the fumble. Okay. As we all watch this, we're all learning together. Looks like it's going to be first and 10 seniors at the 41-yard line. So we have a turnover on downs for the juniors. A plethora of juniors now going onto the field. Wholesale changes.
Wholesale sub coming out. Juniors look to keep that zero on the board for the seniors.
4:50 and with 4 minutes 50 seconds left in the second quarter here. It's now first and 10 at the 41-yard line for the seniors. Again, moving right to left. Coach Shepard out there setting his offense. He stands at the 45. Tightly bunched. We have a timeout. Coach Shepard is questioning personnel changes from the senior side. Probably not the right personnel on the field for that play. Coach Shepard, again, reviewing his notes.
Coach Shepard getting a little crazy out there.
Lining him up correctly. Emilia Corsi, EA Sports 2. Oh, she's taken down hard. So that's number 32. Oh, we have a little. A little extracurricular activity possibly. Number 32, Emily Corsi, EA Sports 2, is her nickname on this lineup sheet for us, was taken out of bounds by number 54, Dana Hay. D. Wade was the one forcing her out of bounds. She did hit hard on the turf, but got back up. Coach Shepard getting his team in a huddle. They're on the left hash, closest to the press box side.
Senior offense comes out in the gun.
Seniors line up. 87 in motion. Motion left to right. Number seven passes off to 02.
And the flag will be taken.
By number 02, Holly Shepard, thing two.
Run by Holly Shepard.
And that brings up a first down for the seniors. So seniors making some progress on this drive in the second quarter with 3:43 in the running clock.
Short pass from Lexi Irwin, number seven.
Lexi Irwin, number seven, on that quarterback pass to the right. Tonight's attendance, as just estimated by Ticket Counts at the gate, 17,335, a new record for Joe P. T. McCullough Stadium. We want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. Check that. Looks about 1,500.
For tonight's 2013 Powder Puff game between the junior and the senior class.
Seniors in a shotgun.
Shotgun formation, seniors.
Number seven with a pass. Lexi Irwin again in the shotgun, throws over the center. Pass was defended by number 24, Christy Rosem. Crust on the defense, number 24, Christy Rosem. She was able to obtain that flag. Gets another first and 10 for the seniors. Seniors just outside of the 15-yard line. Looks about first and 10 from the 16-yard line. Again, moving right to left. Coach Shepard once again getting his troops lined up.
Seniors in the gun. Hand off.
Number three.
Outside, near sidelines. That's Emily Corsi.
We have a stoppage of play. Looks like they were run out of bounds.
And she will be out of bounds, short of the touchdown.
Emily, of course, number 32, EA Sports on a run to the right. Looks like she got a first down. Will be first and goal from the 4-yard line for the seniors. First and goal.
But will he listen?
Again, clock is running. First and goal from the 4-yard line. 1:28 left in the first half. 1:51. Where are we getting these numbers from? We really don't know. That explains a lot. We have seniors running the clock, so they're resetting it, allow for peer mediation here, remediation. Direct snap to number three, Jessica Furstenmeyer. It's picked off, and it's running. She's at the 50, the 45, the 40, the 35, the 30, the 25, the 20, the 15, the 10, 5. Oh! It's not a touchdown. She looks like she was dragged down from behind about the 1-yard line.
Just short of
As soon as she gets up from being passed out from exhaustion, we'll get a number for you. All right, we just got word back in the booth. Caitlin Cicillo, number 18, Killer Kate, intercepted that ball approximately the goal line, ran it back like an NFL defensive back, a la Rod Woodson, all the way down to the one-yard line where the juniors take over first and goal for the one. Check that. Officials have marked the ball approximately the 2.5-yard line. First and goal for the juniors. They are making this their presence felt so far in this first half. Seniors got, again, their backs against the wall and against the goal line. Shotgun formation.
Shotgun formation from the junior offense.
Swing pass to the right, number 87. Can't see because of the wall. Oh, she's out of bounds approximately the 1-yard line.
Number 87, Tara
Savisky, of volleyball fame here at West Allegheny, was able to take that ball and run to the right. Looks like no gain, maybe even a little bit of a loss on that play. Second and goal from the three. Clock is running, under 1 minute to play. We're trying to call a play in from the sidelines. Slight confusion, but we're lined up again in the shotgun set. Mackenzie Johnson hands off. Oh, and we do have a tackle in the backfield. Tackle by number 17, Rachel Smith. Just plain Smith is her nickname. And we do have a timeout, I believe. Juniors called a timeout. We had a loss of about 4 on the play. Be third and goal from the 7.5-yard line. Juniors huddling up, getting ready to call their play. Ball's on the left hash. Again, moving left to right this time. Juniors heading to our right in the press box. 29 seconds left, third and goal.
Junior offense coming back at it again to the gun. Number 4, Mackenzie Johnson.
Mackenzie Johnson in the shotgun. High snap. High snap. Number 6, Sarah Davis takes the ball again. And she is in for the touchdown. Number 6, Sarah Davis gets her second touchdown of the game here at Joe P. DeMcCollum Stadium, and the juniors fall down again. Juniors bringing it tonight. Smalls, number 6. She is small, but she is fast. Demonstrating to the officials that her belt is attached properly and that everything's functioning in the correct manner. Again, these girls are wearing 3 flags on the belt, 2 on the side, 1 on the back end. Going for the extra point, number 4 is your holder, Mackenzie Johnson. T. Savvy, she's lined up basically in Hopewell to kick this ball. And she gets it through the uprights. So with 24 seconds left here in the first half, you're scored juniors 14, seniors 0. As we come back to play shortly, the seniors have a short period of time to work their magic to try and get that goose egg off the board and get back on with a score of their own.
Pull some strings to draw some blood here in the first half.
Looking at some of the past scores, again, last year's score 26-0 by the seniors. That was the current seniors were juniors last year. They lost 26-0. Year before was again 7-6, which was a close one. In 2010 was 32-6 in favor of the seniors. Again, seniors have been predominant in this annual contest of pure athleticism on the golden gridiron.
Coming at each other's throat, seniors and juniors. Can the seniors get on the board, please?
Our senior PA announcers pleading with their senior class members to try and get on the board. Audra Killen, number 39. Ooh, Killen is holding it as number T Savvy kicks the ball off.
At the 30-yard line, kicked off.
Ball's about the 32-yard line. She's running, and she is now down at approximately the 46-47 yard line. Again, moving right to left. Looks like it's going to be first and 10 for the seniors moving towards the end zone away from the scoreboard. Coach Shepard again rallying the troops. Getting ready with 13 seconds left here in the first half. First and 10, ball on the 46 for the seniors. Kicking tee still laying on the field. Obviously, that's a projectile we don't want down there. We're hoping Matt Treves can stay warm tonight without having to do anything sports medicine-wise for our participants. Seniors break the huddle. Again, going from left to right on the right hash. Shotgun. It's like a sidecar to the right with it. We have a fake pass, number 19, on the juniors. Number 19, Elena Fritz Kraka, number 19, passes the ball off to the right. Not after that play. Looks like they got a first and 10. As soon as we get a number for the runner on that play, we'll bring that to you. We don't know who ran the ball. We do know it was a senior, and it looks like it was maybe an eligible number. Once again, our tech crew, at Team High Pod for you Twitter followers. And again, at WA Sports Network. Seniors lining up in the shotgun.
Seniors coming out in the shotgun. Aubrey
split
Ayers,
back. He fakes the pass. Going to go around to the left. Oh, we got a flag, and out again. That was number 8. Maggie Ingram was the ball carrier running around to the left. Tackle by number 54, Dana Hay, D. Wade, bringing the speed, able to make that stop. Again, at the half, the 2013 version of the junior-senior Powder Puff game, your junior is 14, senior 0. We'll be right back after this short message and timeout.
Powder Puff is a football game held at many high schools around the country. At West Allegheny, Powder Puff is a football game held for the senior girls versus the junior girls. It's a lot of fun, it's flag football, and the girls who participate in it really enjoy themselves.
All of the proceeds from this game will be benefiting Christmas families, so NHS will go out and buy toys for children of underprivileged families. And if you'd like to make a donation, you can contact Mrs. Lambert or ask the high school office.
Otter Pub game.
Again, we want to take a moment to obviously thank the tech crew tonight for the ability to put this on. Mr. Jordan Grogan, Mr. Joe Falcioni, Mr. Dakota Lamb, Mr. Jeremy Ellis, our PA announcers, seniors, Mr. Eli Kucevich, and Mr. Mike Ross. Our spotter tonight, Mr. Ian McBain. Obviously, it takes a lot of people to put this on behind. These guys have done a great job all year putting the WA Sports Network and creating it and putting it on air. So we want to thank them for the enjoyment we've been able to watch our football teams and hopefully other sports in the near future. Start the second half. Our juniors will be kicking off from the 40, moving again left to right. Quick kick. Ball comes down. Received at the 35-yard line by number 17. She takes it to the right. She's making some room. Number 17, Rachel Smith, picks the ball up on the 35-yard line. Her cross-country and track experience coming into play at that point. Defending on the play was a plethora of Indians. Seniors will start the ball on the junior half of the field. First and 10 from the 33-yard line. Number 87 for the juniors. Tara Savisky, T. Savvy, making her presence known both special teams and defensively. Seniors line up in the shotgun.
Seniors in the shotgun. Aubrey Ayers from the
gun. Aubrey Ayers fakes throw pass. Oh, we have a tackle, number 87 again for the seniors was Sarah Becker. Trying to make her way around left side, got to about the left hash and was tackled.
Second and nine for the seniors.
Tackled by number 54 in a junior class. Again, 54 being Dana Hay. Again, Dee Wade making her presence known. Public over the PA system. Gentlemen, let's get some original material. Thank you. Again, second and nine for the seniors.
Not too happy about us taking his sayings.
Seniors break the huddle. Coach Shepard looking at the clock, running 6 minutes.
Mr. Shepard, you are not allowed to play for the offense.
Shotgun.
In the gun, Aubrey Ayers.
Aubrey Ayers, number 19. Oh, we have a completed pass. Completed. Oh. Hold that. Incomplete. Ball was about on a 15-yard line. She got over behind the defensive backfield, was able to get her hands on the ball, but couldn't hold on to the catch. That'll bring up a third and nine for the seniors. Again, a plethora of changes for the Indians on the junior side of the ball.
No male cheerleaders this year except one, and that seems to be Mr. Shepard out on the field.
This just in, we've just been identified that we do not have senior male cheerleaders. We do have one cheerleader, Mr. Shepard. He is doing his best to rally the troops there on the field. Thank you, boys. Seniors line up. Aubrey Ayers in the shotgun. To the left, number 8, Michaela Gardner, and her shotgun. Oh, almost picked off by number 71 on the defensive play, Rachel Lawrence Arlar. Brings up 4th and 9 for the seniors.
That was number 71, Rachel Lawrence Arlar, batting that one down.
Rachel reacting to the crowd. Very much appreciative of the cheers. Seniors huddling up about at least 3/4 of a mile away from the ball. Gives them enough extra time to think about the offensive play they need to call.
Keeping the goose egg on the board there. Looking like the high school team's defense there.
Thank you. Yes, we were not given rules for the game, so we were winging it, just like sometimes the offense seems to be for the seniors.
Senior offense going for this one.
Aubrey's fourth and, oh, we could have a false start. We have some confusion in the backfield. Oh, tripped up. Tripped up by number 20 on the play, Mackenzie Sadowskis, defensive back. Number 26 for the seniors, Alyssa Amadio, double A squared, was somewhat perturbed due to the fact that she was brought down unofficially, apparently in her opinion, into that run. So we had somewhat of a opportunity for the seniors to cash in and make a first down. They did not, so turnover on downs. Juniors will start the game, or I'm sorry, start this series, their first of the second half. First and 10 from the 30. Again, working from our left to their right.
Once again, number 30, the Reaper, putting on her gloves. Ready for a big run.
Seniors getting their lineup together, their personnel. Juniors waiting for them patiently.
Juniors on the 30-yard line. Seniors just broke the huddle.
Shotgun. A double reverse, number 30 to the left side. She's got clear room. She's going to, she keep going. Forced out of bounds at approximately the 35-yard line. Number 40 for this for the juniors running. Is that 40? Can we get a confirmation on the runner on that? Lauren Costa, check that, number 30, the ball carrier on that double reverse. Number 30, Reaper, again is her nickname. Laura Costa, again, of the WPI on PLA cross country and actually track fame.
Got some wheels on the turf and the track.
We have a first and 10. They spotted the ball just outside the 45-yard line, so it's first and 10 for the juniors. 43-yard line.
Senior defense,
we have shotgun again. Again, high snap, number 13. Sailor Davis comes around right side, works her way back across the grain. Sarah Davis takes the ball. She's at the 30, the 25, the 20, the 15, the 10. Brought down and stopped out of bounds. Belt ripped off about the 12-yard line. Sarah Davis all over the gridiron tonight. Brought down by number 69 on that tackle, Megan Strip, Megatron, bringing down Smalls. So that brings up a first and 10 for the juniors just outside the 10-yard line. So first and 10 from the 12-yard line. Running clock at 1:15 now. Shotgun. High snap again. Seems to be working for him, though.
High snap.
Oh, we have...
Seems to be a collision there.
Down, round number... Looks like we have Taylor Hottenfeller as a quarterback taking the pitch to the right. Brought down by number 38
Taylor
from the senior class.
From the gun there.
Carly Cardillo, Carmageddon, brought her down. Hot and spicy. Again, the quarterback for the juniors on that carry, working around to the right. Brought down by, again, number 38, Carmageddon. Juniors and seniors both break the huddle. We got two wide receivers to the right.
Johnson in the gun, scrambles.
Kaylee Johnson. Oh, just out of the reach of number two from the junior class. Number two again being Buck Wild, Rachel Buck.
For number two, Rachel Buck Wild.
In and out, she had room to just dance right into the end zone.
Volleyball star, West Allegheny.
That'll bring up, after that last loss on the fumble, brings up a third and Approximately 15. Again, that is the end of the third quarter. Again, score remaining the same, 14-0 in favor of the juniors. Also want to remind you to subscribe to Team High Pod's YouTube channel for weekly varsity football pump-up videos, youtube.com/TeamHighPod.
Specifically my mother.
Mike Ross being chastised by his mother tonight. Apparently Mike does not know how to use the flip switch on the thing, and his mother had to bring him to task. Again, Mike being a senior here at West Allegheny, one of the multiple members of our football team. Mike is always being a upstanding student-athlete representative of West Allegheny.
Here we go. He's playing it off. Oh, he threw a flag. I think that's for me. Very nice, Mr. Official.
Junior's lining up. I'm not sure if they have those flags set right. I think they missed up on gave him an extra 5 yards back, so it's third and 10 from the 12. Mackenzie Johnson works to the left side. She's got some running room. She goes down to the left side. She's forced out of bounds at approximately the 7-yard line. Number 76 on the seniors. Emma Wilson mid-wheels. Number 70. Emma Wilson forcing her out of bounds on the left-hand sideline. Brings up a 4th and 2 at approximately the 8-yard line.
Touchdown. Can this be a repeat of 2009?
We have, again, at the shotgun position, Hot and Spicy's at the quarterback, Smalls at the tailback position, shotgun, single back, I formation, split two receivers to the right, snock shotgun, passing off to the right, number 87, Tara Savisky, she's going untouched into the end zone. Third touchdown for the juniors tonight. Again, the end zone dance accompanied by those on the sideline with a fall down. Very nice. Juniors, again, putting 6 more points on the board in that round run to the right. Number 87, Tara Savvy.
Spanish for nothing, I believe.
Tara Savisky, number 87, showing at that athleticism. Looks like we're looking for a kicking tee. We're waiting for our holder. Again, that would be junior Mackenzie Johnson. Awkward. Again, awkward not being on the field appropriately at the right time. Again, awkward. Now set for to receive the ball as a holder. T-Savvy lining it up, and it's through the uprights. Point is good. Point after is good by T. Savvy. So she scores 6 and points an extra exclamation point on for 7 points. T. Savvy taking it all her own on that one. So right now your scoreboard should reflect 21-0 in favor of the juniors. Our tech guys are so excited about the action on the field they could not update the ticker across the top of your screen. We still have a running clock of 6:54, but the score at some point I'm sure will be corrected. There we go, 21-0 in favor of the juniors. Juniors could if they come through this game unscathed and win, they have the momentum going into their senior year. Those sophomores who are out there either at the game tonight or listening online, you got your work cut out for you next year. Juniors, some of them are straying into the senior side of the field. We need to get them corralled over the other side and get them lined up on the right side of the 40.
Like a star, seeing his junior shine tonight.
T. Savvy lines the ball up at the 40. Get the signal from the officials, and we're ready to kick off. Going again from right to left. She boots it a la Dave Brightus, at Brightus official. And we got a runner. Comes down hard. We have questions from the seniors. How can that happen? Well, she ran into another object and made her fall down. We have a belt on the field at the 28-yard line. I don't believe that was a ball carrier. Ball carrier on that for the seniors was. Our senior announcers here can't pick it up either, but they're just so excited that they actually got on the other side of the 50.
Extremely excited.
Tackle made by a plethora of juniors.
Sorry, someone thinks a phone call is very important.
I'm not sure exactly who's on the phone with Mike Ross. It might be the President of the United States trying to break through to congratulate the juniors, as he annually does in high-profile athletic contests. Or maybe he's trying to let everybody know that the healthcare.gov website's up to snuff and running. Aubrey-Ayers passes off to the right to, I believe that's 26. 26 being... for the seniors, Alyssa Mario, double A, number 26, to the right-hand side. She looks like she picks up her first down. Brought down in the play by number 54 for the juniors. Again, being Dana Hay. D Wade, again, small in stature, but she is making her presence known tonight defensively. A couple of new substitutions on for the seniors. Defensive side of the ball for the juniors seems pretty set. One more substitution going off for the seniors. Again, first and 10 with that run brings the ball to the 35-yard line. Seniors behind by three scores, you would think would want to try and expedite their run up to the line and get their offensive play call.
They know that this is going to be the drive to turn things around.
Mr. Shepard again leading the troops. Oh, we have a switch in the shotgun. Emily Corsi, straight shot in the Wildcat, makes it to the left-hand side. Play tackle by number 64 for the juniors, that being Kira Asatelli, Kira-Ra, number 64. If I'm not saying that right, I apologize, Kira. Ki-Ray-Ray, Kira-Ra. I need to get a phonetic dictionary next year if I'm still around. If I'm getting asked to be asked back. Never know with the tech crew again, led by Mr. Grogan and Mr. Falcioni. Seniors break the huddle. Second and 5 from the 31-yard line. Again, moving left to right towards the end zone with the scoreboard. We have a straight line of three backs. Number 7 hands off to looks like, I think it is, number 7, Lexi Irwin, hands off to number 41, Detta Daniels.
That's Detta Daniels on that run.
Detta Daniels of cheerleading fame and basketball here for West Allegheny. Seniors pick up a first down, first and 10 from the 19-yard line.
Cheerleader Detta Daniels there on the run. That's XO.
Seniors break the huddle. Again, same formation as previously. Bad snap. Bad snap, and we have number 05 for the juniors. Juniors number 05, Cassidy Lally, or Lollipop.
Cassidy Lally, Lollipop on the stop.
She makes a stop. Loss of approximately 3 or 4 on the play.
Seniors looking to
brings up third
here.
And 13 with 2:26 left in the game. Timing is not on the senior side right now. Down 3 scores. When the Mr. Shepard's a geography person, I'm sure he knows enough algebra and math to say that that is not in his team's favor.
2 minutes left.
We have close coming up on a 2-minute warning. Again, they're lined up. We have a fumble snap. 28. Michaela Gardner takes it down the right-hand side. Michaela's forced out. at approximately the 7 or 8 yard line.
She'll be out of bounds around the 3 yard line.
She does get the first down, so first and goal for the seniors at the 7 yard line.
Putting the seniors in great field positioning.
Seniors almost trying to get that goose egg off. Juniors feeling the impending victory in their hands. They're all lining up at the 25-yard line inside the team box. Counts getting down to close to 1 minute left in the game. They line up again in the straight shotgun eye slot. Hand off to number 41. Looks like Detta Daniels. Detta Daniels gets in for the score for the seniors. The seniors get that goose egg off the board with a point after to be tried in just a minute. 1:04 left in the contest, 21-6, and again in favor of the juniors. Mr. Shepard huddles his seniors. Again, wholesale changes on the defensive front for the juniors. Again, as we annually do, we want to take the opportunity to thank everyone for coming out tonight, whether you're online or in person, supporting this great cause. Again, tonight's efforts through the National Honor Society of the High School, in all seriousness, work to benefit our families for a special Christmas for them this upcoming year. Waiting for the tee to come in for the seniors. Looks like they got the tee, but maybe nobody to kick or to hold.
1 minute left, seniors.
What can Mr. Not sure if Mr. Shepard's
around for the seniors at this point in the game. Let's hope the seniors can pull off something because there's
Mr. Shepard is. Oh, apparently we got
class,
the wrong tee out there. Mr. Shepard's looking for not the kicking kickoff tee, but the PAT tee. Right, does that sound right? PAT? Yeah.
Smarter than me.
We'll
too.
Let that go. As we're waiting for the placement to get in place for the folks that kick the PAT, I also remind you to subscribe to the Team High Pods YouTube channel for weekly varsity pump-up videos. Again, that web address is youtube.com/teamhighpod. Seniors ready to snap the ball. Number 76 is holding. And number 22... Emma Wilson, mid-wills, holds for number 22. Abby Ward, absled, gets it through the upright. So your score at this point, juniors 21, seniors 7.
By Maggie Ingram. And the kick's off for the seniors.
We're kicking off for the seniors. Seniors kick off again from left to right. Picked up by number 39, Audra Killen. Audra's flag gets lost at approximately the 29-yard line. That much is known in flag football. When you lose your flag and you are the ball carrier, when you lose that flag, you are down immediately, whether some other player touched you or not. So, again, juniors take over first and 10 at the 29. Juniors lining up, ready to go. Seniors, again, still speculating on the defensive side of the ball. We have a strong formation up front for the juniors. Looks like a 1950s wedge block.
For the juniors. Still gets the pitch off.
Oh.
Taken down in the backfield. Flags off.
Number 6.
By the senior defense there.
Sarah Third Davis tries to take a sweep toss to the left. She loses approximately 5 yards in the play for the juniors. Second and 15. We now have a timeout from the seniors. Coach Shepard using that timeout. There is no red flag or challenge play today in the game, I don't believe, because we don't have the technical difficulties at this point in the game. Although if we had another game left, I'm sure we could rig up something with the technical crew that we have with some sort of replay challenge. probably on an iPod that these guys could furnish on the sideline, and they can share that with the guys in stripes and make sure that they get the correct call. Here we go, back to action again. Juniors over the ball, seniors getting set defensively. We have trips left. We have five wide, three to the left, two to the right. Tara Savisky's, I'm sorry, check that. Taylor Hottenfeller, she gets knocked to the ground. Taylor Hottenfeller knocked to the ground as she lets go of the pass. She almost, ball got to the 39-yard line, which if caught would have been close to a first down. Substitution changes on the side for the juniors. Seniors look like they're set with their defensive alignment.
We have about 9 seconds left in the game.
The running clock is not running right now. It's more of a stalemate position, and that's just to give the girls a little bit extra time to get out there and enjoy the night's festivities. Shotgun approach.
And pass away.
Nice spiral. Nice spiral pass by Mackenzie Johnson to Buck Wild, who makes the reception. And ladies and gentlemen, that's your ball game. The 2013 version of the Powder Puff Annual Gridiron Classic. Juniors 21, seniors 7. Again, set for a rematch for seniors next year. This spring coming up, I'm told. It's unofficial? No. Unofficial. It's not official, but they get together anyway. So on behalf of everybody in the crew in the box, again, those folks who are bringing you the video and audio portion of tonight's game, the tech crew of Jordan Grogan, Joe Falcioni, Dakota Lamb, Jeremy Ellis, our PA announcers, Eli Kucevich and Mike Ross, and our spotter, Ian McBain. I'm Dave McBain, athletic director of West Allegheny. Thanks very much for participating. Best of luck in your future endeavors. And again, we'll see you back here next year.